After introducing the MC basic algorithm, let's turn to another algorithm called MC Exploring Starts, which is an extension of MC Basic. We've previously mentioned the advantages of MC Basic, that is, it can help us clearly understand how to realize model-free reinforcement learning using Monte Carlo methods. However, its disadvantage lies in its low efficiency, making it too simple to be practical. We now extend it to be more efficient. How to do that? First, let's consider an example in a grid world environment where we follow a policy pie and obtain an episode. We introduce a new concept called visit, which means that every time a state action pair appears in the episode, it's called a visit of that state action pair. In MC Basic, we typically use the initial visit method. What does it mean? It means that for each episode, we only consider S1, A2, and we use the return obtained from the remaining part of the episode to estimate the action value of S1, A2, and approximate Qpi S1, A2. The problem with this approach is that it doesn't fully utilize the episode. Many samples are wasted. Why is this so? Let's look at the original episode. Apart from visiting S1, A2, it also visits S2, A4, S1, A2 again, S2, A3, and S5, A1. If we ignore the initial part and consider the subsequent part starting from S2, A4, we get a new episode. This new one. This new episode can be used to estimate the action value of S2, A4. Similarly, the remaining parts can be used to estimate the action values of S1, A2, S2, A3, S5, A1, and so on. This way, the data is utilized more efficiently. Here we have two methods, first visit and every visit. There is a slight difference between them. Let's look at this example. Here it visited S1 A2 on the first time and then visited S1 A2 again on the third time. What does it mean for the every visit method? It means that regardless of how many times I visit, as long as I have visited it, I can use the return of all subsequent samples to estimate the action value of S1 A2. With this method, I will estimate S1 A2 again based on the later samples. However, for the first visit method, I only use the first visit. When it visits for the second time, I will not use the subsequent ones to update its estimation. In addition to making data utilization more efficient, we can also make policy updates more efficient. There are two methods for this as well. The first method, also used in MC Basic, involves collecting all the episodes starting from a state action pair, averaging their returns to approximate the action value. However, the problem with this method is that the agent has to wait until all episodes have been collected, leading to time wastage and low efficiency. The second method is to immediately estimate the action value using the return of a single episode and then proceed to improve the policy without waiting for all episodes to finish. In this way, we can improve the policy episode by episode and improve efficiency. Some may say that the return of a single episode cannot accurately approximate the corresponding action value. In fact, we have done similar things in the truncated policy iteration algorithm introduced in the last chapter. Truncated policy iteration involves two steps. The first step is policy evaluation, where we need to compute the state value for the current policy by solving the Bellman equation, which typically requires an infinite number of iterations. How did we handle this at that time? We performed a finite number of iterations. While this finite iteration may not yield highly precise state values, the algorithm remains effective nonetheless. This idea is also applicable here, where we use one episode to estimate action value. It is not precise, but it doesn't matter. These methods actually fall into the scope of generalized policy iteration, abbreviated as GPI. GPI is not a specific algorithm. It refers to the general idea or framework of switching between policy evaluation and policy improvement processes. In policy evaluation, there's no need to precisely estimate action values or state values. Algorithms introduced in the previous lecture and those discussed in this lecture can fit into the GPI framework. With these considerations, we can get a new algorithm called MC Exploring Starts. What is Exploring Starts? I will talk about it later. Now we only need to know that MC Exploring Starts is essentially an extension of the MC Basic algorithm we previously studied. The aim of this extension is to enhance efficiency. Here's an overview of the pseudocode, First, episode generation. Then perform policy evaluation and policy improvement. For details, please refer to the book. Here, I only touch on one point. Suppose we have an episode like this, S1A1 to S2A2, S3A3, S4A4, and so on. What would be the normal procedure to use the data? I would start with the first visit, which is S1A1, and go through all state action pairs. The first one is this, and then I sum up all the subsequent rewards to get the return, which serves as an estimate for the action value of S1A1. Then I would proceed to the next one, S2A2, and sum up all the subsequent rewards again for the return. The same for S3A3 and S4A4. However, as you can see here, this algorithm starts from the end instead of starting from the beginning. Why? It's actually to enhance computational efficiency. Let me explain through an example. Here is what's going on. Suppose I've already computed the later part. The sum of the subsequent rewards gives us this return, denoted as G. Now, when I'm calculating S3A3, I don't need to sum up all the rewards following it. What do I do instead? Let's say the immediate reward I receive from S3A3 is R. Then, adding R to gamma G gives us the return from S3A3. I then take this as a new G, which can be used to calculate the return for S2A2. Similarly, it's R plus gamma G, where R is the reward obtained from S2A2. This backward inference allows us to efficiently compute the return. So, when you're looking at various algorithms, do they look so complex? Now you know that it's all about using these small tricks to enhance computational efficiency. Why do we need to consider exploring starts? Why is it necessary? Let's analyze this further. To understand this, we can focus closely on the meanings of these two words, exploring and starts. What does exploring refer to? It means that I need to have many episodes visiting every SA. Only then can I use the returns of these episodes to estimate the action value. If we don't have any episodes visiting a state action pair, then I may not be able to estimate its action value correctly. So, to ensure optimality, we need to make sure that every SA is visited. That's the essence of exploring. Now, what about starts? It means that I need to have many episodes starting from every state action pair, SA. There are two methods for this. The first method is to start an episode from SA. The second method is to start from another SA, but also pass through the SA of interest. This is called a visit. And both methods are acceptable. However, for the second method, how can I ensure that starting from another SA will definitely visit the SA of interest? I can't guarantee. Therefore, the straightforward approach is to ensure that every state action pair, SA, is the starting point of at least one episode. This is called exploring starts. Next, we introduce a new algorithm that can avoid the exploring starts condition, which may be difficult to achieve in practice. For instance, in a grid-world example where we want a real robot to start from different SA, we would need to physically move the robot and set up the program, which may be unrealistic. So, there's a gap between theory and practice. Can we remove the requirement of exploring starts? The answer is yes. We can achieve this by using soft policies, which leads us to the fourth part, MC without exploring starts. Here we'll introduce an algorithm called MC epsilon greedy.